Baby, this is do or die. Feel it in my veins tonight. Emotional suicide. You know it's a knife or eye. I didn't wanna walk, didn't wanna walk the plank. No. But the Mariona, it came like the thunder.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to round number two for SMB's F1 series here at the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. The Jeddah Street Circuit is a tight, sweeping, and high-speed circuit full of blind corners and fast chicanes. But before we have a look at qualifying, let's find out a bit more about Saudi Arabia.
Welcome from the Jeddah Street Circuit for what we hope is going to be a gripping spectacle of racing. It's time to get underway as we join the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. So let's take a look at the topographical map of the Jeddah Street Circuit. As you can see, a number of challenging corners for the drivers to master here. We'll see just how much the teams have benefited from their time spent in practice this weekend. And like many street circuits, this track has the potential to punish drivers that get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid any safety cars today.
Last week at Bahrain, we saw Mayor of Bag City sit atop the charts, capturing pole. But it was Rangers who quickly took the lead at race start, and he never looked back. So I want to take a look at points from last week. It's pretty close for some of these guys, but Rangers, he definitely has a nice point lead. So let's take a look at that. Rangers, you see him up there with 26 points. Mayor of Bag City, who did have pole, he's up there with 18 points. Jacob99, who looks very, very fast tonight, he's got 15 points. Culture, another fast one tonight. He's got 12 points in the standings. Bloomy with 10. Hokey Fan sitting in 6th with 8 points. Justin in 7th with 6. Polish with 4 points. J Mac Attack with 2 points. Blue Husky running at the top 10 with a single point here. Let's go to the constructor standings for the teams. Now, look how close this is for Ferrari and Aston Martin. 1 point away from each other. So the battle is heating up for these guys already just after race one. So we have 33 for Ferrari. Aston Martin has 32. McLaren has 18. Mercedes with 14. Williams with 4. And we have Red Bull with 1 point there. So I'm kind of curious what tonight is going to bring. I think it's going to be pretty close, but I think we're going to see a safety car or two tonight. Last week, we didn't see any guys, so very clean race. Tonight, though, let's talk about this. Saudi Arabia, one of my favorite tracks out here. It's fast. It has those chicanes. You really have to know how to drive this track. Let's talk about the lap times we have seen so far. A 130.7 for Jacob99 in practice. Culture was out there with a 131. Mayor and Rangers, those were your four top drivers so far. in the speed charts for practice. Right now, we are in qualifying with just over 14 minutes left. Shames gets on the board with a 134.7. We have a couple of drivers out there. Hokie Fan with a 131.6. So already bringing out those times. So you gotta love it. Evan, what's up? How are you doing? Next week is going to be Baku, and I'll tell you, the castle track is gonna be a wild one. A lot of twisty turns there going through. So I think there's gonna be a lot to watch out for next week. I'm excited for it, but it's one of those races where I'm glad I'm in the booth. Right now we're watching Hokie Fan at 131.6. What is this? A 129.7 for Jacob. He is just absolutely flying. I'm loving the speed that he is showing so far. Myth, I missed you up there. How you doing? I hope you're doing well. Oh, man. Yeah, these guys running some fast times already. A 129. That's a second faster than what we saw in practice, which was put up by him. He had a 130.7. So some good times for these guys so far. Bloomy with a 130.978, so not too far off. We have Culture, who just went up there with a 130.3, so he's another fast one, and I love the speed that he is showing this season. Last week, Rangers won. He won last season, so that's back-to-back races for him throughout the seasons. He also won here at Saudi Arabia last season. So I'm curious, will he go back to back once again, not only from last week, but also last season? There's a lot that can go on in this race tonight to see what he does. But Mayor of Bag City, we saw him sit it on the pole last week. We'll see if he can do it again. I think we're going to see probably a few penalties out there also, which is something that these guys are going to have to watch. So they've already been talking about, we have to stay ahead of the guy behind us. And Jordan made a joke. He said, I want to stay ahead of the guy behind me by at least like 30 seconds. So, you know, some of these guys are expecting some penalties throughout this track. Let's go on board with Justin right now. And we'll see why. If you don't know much about this track, we'll see why you would want to stay away from the penalties. Very, very easy to get here. There's some places where it's kind of hard to see where the track limits are, and they will be quick to give you those penalties. Well, it looks like he's gonna come in, so let's hitch a ride with someone else here. This is gonna be Bloomy, sitting third so far in sector two. We're going to have three DRS zones, so quite a few places where you can get a lot of speed. And you can see on the right side, there's not a lot of places where you can tell that you need to be and stay away from. So a couple of these spots are going to be a little tricky and can easily go over those limits and get you in trouble. Bloomy doing a great job out here so far. Nice straightaways, but as we're coming up here, you're gonna have that first chicane. We're gonna have to watch that in the race. You guys know I say it all the time. If you can make it past lap one, turn one, you're gonna be okay. I've heard from some drivers saying I'm not worried about the first turn and the first chicane. I'm worried more about the end of sector one, and that is coming up here. Some of these fast curves that you have to get around when you're trying to make those passes, it can get very tricky around here. So we'll see how they can handle those situations. Bloomy looking good so far. Coming up on the end of sector one, heading into sector two. All right, let's hitch a ride with Jacob. Oh, well, he's in the pit. So is Culture. Bloomy in third. Justin with a 131.2. Hokie Fan, 131.6. Looking good in top five. We have Jacob. How about this? Out P6, 132.9. Oh, no, it's Shames. He's going to have a 134.7. We do have a bit of a caution in Sector 2. We'll see who that is. I do believe that's going to be Bloomy, but he is off and running once again. A 129.5 for Mayor of Bag City. That is going to move him up into the pole position. Last week, he did sit and pole. Man, this is crazy. We'll see if we can get that again tonight. I'm waiting for Rangers. You know, if you've watched Rangers, he takes his time. He doesn't come out there early on. He wants to kind of see what the charts are doing and then just blow by everyone. It's kind of wild. Pump, I am on Xbox. We have a driver that is on PC, but the rest of these drivers, as you can see, they are all on Xbox. Few drivers in pit lane. We have Bloomy making his way. Hokie fan. Oh, a little bit of contact with the wall there. Just don't do that in race. Let me know what you guys think about Baku. I know we're at Saudi Arabia and this is my favorite track. But let me know what you think about Baku. Wild track, really fun, but yeah, like I said, that is a track where I'm glad I'm in the booth. Jacob with that 132 in the pits. Shames 134.4. Dion 137.3. The rest of these guys, Polish Rangers, J-Mac, I'm not sure why he's not in the lobby just yet, but Blue Husky has yet to go out. David is on his outlap at Mayor. These laps, pretty incredible, I have to say. Already faster than what we saw in practice by a little over half a second, so very interesting. Actually, over a second. The fastest in practice was a 130.7 put down by Jacob 99. Who is literally a second faster than what he did in practice. Baku is fun. It is crazy, though. The scenery, trying to make your way through the castle portion, absolutely insane. Pump, how long have you been racing on F1? A little bit of contact there for Hokie. J-Mac crashed his car. Okay, does that mean he cannot do the race? I'm newer to F1, guys, so yeah. I really hope he can do the race. There, that'd be terrible if he couldn't. About 2 months. Okay. Yeah, I don't have a lot of experience like racing on here at all. Literally none. He just starting and okay. I gotcha. All right, no one is able to pass Mayor of Bag City just yet. Jacob still hanging out in second. Culture with a 130.3. Bloomy so close behind with a 130.4. But take a look at this. Polish Hammer with a 130.492. Man, the battle between fourth and fifth for time is just so crazy close. Hokie fan with a 130.9, Justin 131.2, Jacob 132.9, Shames is on board with a 134.4, Dion makes it on the board with a 137.3, Blue Husky is out there with a 143.9, I'm sure he's looking to improve his time, but man, we have a few cautions out there, Sector 1 and 3. Blue Husky is going to be one of them as he tries to get back up to speed here. Rangers finally on his outlap, so I'm very curious to see what he is able to do here. Pump, you want to join in? Have you been in our Discord? I don't know that you'll be able to join in tonight, but if you join the Discord and talk to Dion, you'd probably be able to join next week. I can get you the Discord link. If you've already talked to him, I'm sure you're more than welcome to join. There is the Discord link. Be sure to join in the Discord server here for SMB. That is my club. Okay. Sounds good. All right, Ranger still on that outlap. We're gonna see what he does as he makes his way around. You have to use every single portion of this track to get that best time. So many beautiful turns around here. I just absolutely love the lines that you have to take around this track. So many S-curves, chicanes, you name it. Very, very fast, but man, you have to make sure that you know this track and know that you can depend on how the car is going to react, and you have to make sure that you hit those marks. I'm not winning in the first race I do. Okay. I don't think I'd win in any, to be honest. I'm curious, though. I'm going to keep on here with Rangers. He won an insanely whopping 8 races last season. He won the championship and also the constructors' standings there. Just incredible. He races with us on the NASCAR side also, but I'll tell you what, he just, with these cars, it is absolutely wild how well he does. In 2 years, you can get Discord. That's a while. All right, Rangers goes into pits. He's gonna keep me he's gonna keep me guessing, I guess. All right, a lot of guys in pits right now. Bloomy, he is out. We've been around since 2016. We've been around for a while. This is our 6th season out in F1. You'll practice over the 2 years. Man, you're gonna be a professional by the time you get out here. But yeah, we've been around since 2016. We've done IndyCar, F1 series. We have a NASCAR division. We're on iRacing. You name it. We're a little all over the place. If it's racing, we love it. yes, we haven't done IndyCar in a while. We ran that on Forza, and we also did it on iRacing. That is redacted now. We no longer can do that. Yeah, we did it on both. We did it on Forza, and we also did it on iRacing. A lot of fun. We had our IndyCar series run on Traction, an esports channel. That was really cool. All right, I'm trying to see if we've had any improvements. Mayor of Bag City still sitting out there with a 129.5 for Ferrari. His teammate right behind him with a 129.7. Culture is going to be out there with Mercedes with a 130.3. His teammate J-Mac has crashed, though. Blue Husky. I'm curious if he had that same incident happen. Yeah, that's not really up to iRacing, though. Unfortunately, that was an IndyCar decision. JC12, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. Brian, what's up? Marcus Erickson, nice. All I'm saying when I get PlayStation Online, because is this cross-platform? It is. Everyone's on Xbox except for Rangers, who is on PC. He used to be on Xbox, but... Where did the time go, you guys? Already. All right, so these guys are going to be finishing out Rangers. I don't think he could wait any last second more than he has. Like, my goodness. Morgs, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. Hope you're doing well. We're missing JC out here. I know. We're missing you out here, though, man. Jacob has so much speed. I really want him to win. I really do. I'm so excited. Like, I'm ready to see him out there in victory lane. Like, let's go. All right, will Rangers be able to do it? He has no time on the board. And if you guys know him, he likes to wait last second. So let's see what he can do. A lot of drivers either wrecked, I assume that's what that means. Bloomy, Jacob, Husky, and J-Mac Attack. The suspense is killing me. Will Rangers be able to do it? We're going to be coming around the final corner. A minute 44 seconds left before the session stops on us. Most drivers have completed qualifying. Question is, what will Rangers get? Here we go. Let's find out. It's not even saying anything. No time. What is this, you guys? All right. I don't think he's going to have enough time to put something on the board. Wow. You guys tell me, you know more about this. Mayor of Bag City may hold on to it, and he improved his time a minute 28.7. These guys, I swear, I don't know where they grab more time from. Like, this is insane. A 128.7, absolutely flying for Mayor of Bag City. Rangers won here last season. He's not going to be able to put a time down tonight in qualifying. Unfortunate for him, he's going to have to start in the back. And if you guys know this, turn one, lap one can be disastrous. So Mayor of Bag City going to be on pole tonight here at Saudi Arabia. Jacob, his teammate for Ferrari, is going to be in second. Culture for Mercedes is going to be in third. Bloomy in fourth. Polish Hammer going to round out the top five. Leave Justin in sixth. Hokey Fan in seventh. Jacob in eighth. Great time for him. David MC in ninth. Oh no, it's Shames. He's going to round out the top 10. Dion in 11. Blue Husky in 12. Rangers in 13. And J-Mac Attack going to round out the field here. Got to go full speed if you want the lead. You can, but nice little chicane there. Might be a little disastrous. I don't know if the field will like you after that. He did not get a time. Miss being there, but watching these guys are awesome. Great group of talent. Yeah, they are. I am envious of how they do what they do. We do have Rangers in the lead for the point standings. Mayor of Bag City is going to be in second. Jacob, 99. He's got 15 points. Let's take a look at it right here. Culture in fourth. And that's another driver. We saw him get a couple of wins last season. I want to see him do the same. Maybe get a few more this season. That would be amazing. But yeah, you can see the points there. 26, 18, 15 for Jacob. 12 for Culture. Bloomy has 10. Hokey Fan, he's got 8. Justin with 6. Polish with 4. J-Mac Attack with 2. And Husky is going to round out the top 10 with a point on the board. These guys are going to be doing their formation lap. So let's get that situated. Let's make sure everything is good to go with this. Looks like these guys are going to be starting on mediums except for teammates David and Shames. They are out here for Haas. We'll see how they do. Different strategy for these two. So we have a fan for Jacob. Let me know if you have a driver that you are rooting for. Plenty of talent out here. You will commentate, Pump says. Also, since F1 16, you've been doing this. I did not announce the first several seasons. I didn't even have the game. So I had someone else announce it for us. But I did last season and this season. I mostly do NASCAR. This is kind of new for me. I'm very new to the F1 scene. I've done NASCAR a lot and IndyCar. Take a look on board with Mayor of Bag City as they are on their formation lap getting ready to go green here at Saudi Arabia. You have to go with Mercedes. Mercedes is going to be Culture and J-Mac. We have a one-stop strategy and two stops. Last week we saw the same, mostly a one-stop strategy. David had a two-stop strategy, and it looks like he might be doing the same tonight. All right, let's line it up. Oh, Polish disqualified from the session. Really unfortunate to see. Why is everyone disqualified? Boys and girls, are you ready? Most are ready, but I'll tell you what. Here we go. And the lights are out at Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. Let's go. Turn one, you guys. You know it's going to be a hard one. Let's see if these guys can make it through okay so far. They're doing all right. I want to take a look at the field here. It looks like I hadn't said they're disqualified, but I don't see any issues. J-Mac is out there. David is out there. All right, let's go back to the front of the field. We have teammates Mayor and Jacob directly next to each other. Rangers already up to P8. Take a look at these guys. Jacob, he held on for so long for these laps. I was really impressed with his run, and tonight he is just looking so strong. He's going to be out there in second. Culture is going to be in third. It's a little intimidating to watch these teammates out in front of you, and they're so strong for Ferrari. You got to compete with a lot with that, so he's wanting some help out there. J-Mac, though, he is sitting P13, so not a lot he can do from back there, but we'll see what he can do by himself up here. Bloomy's got a little competition. You see Polish Hammer directly behind him. Take a look at that. Mayor of Bag City already with a 135.8. Culture looks like he already side by side with Jacob. Take a look at this, battling his teammate out here. Trying to take over P2 heading into it. He takes it over. Gets a little bit of gap between him and Jacob. What a fantastic drive for him so far. Jacob right now just needs to worry about being consistent, hitting those marks and trying to close that gap up to Culture. We'll see what Culture can do. Mayor of Bag City has absolutely benefited from what just happened between his teammate and Culture. A little over a second and a half between those two drivers, between the lead and second, Jacob in third. We're going to have Bloomy in fourth, and Polish not too far behind him, so he's got some time to make that up. Rangers, how about this? Up to P6. Wow, great job from him so far here tonight. Unable to put a time down in qualifying. Mayor of Bag City already getting another fastest lap with a 132. We now have DRS enabled, so these guys can use it if they're in a certain amount of distance between the driver ahead of them. You're going to be using a controller. Nothing wrong with that. You can use controller. Let's take a look at Justin. He's got Rangers in his view. Those are teammates right here. That is going to be for Aston Martin. You can hear Justin really working that Polish already with a 3-second time penalty. Jacob, 3-second time penalty for him. He is sitting P10 right now. Blue Husky, let's take a look at him. Sitting P8. He's got some company directly behind him. That is going to be Hokey Fan. His teammate Bloomy is actually, he's doing a really terrific job up there. Lap 3 of 25, still a ton of racing left to do, but man, what a fantastic start. Yeah, we do have some penalties out here. That is something that these drivers will have to watch. It came into effect last race, it will for this. Next week, I think we're going to see quite a few penalties. Not a lot of give at Baku. Here we go, another battle brewing up as we go side by side. J-Mac Attack battling it out with David. We'll see if J-Mac is able to overtake him going into the corner here. He is able to do it. He takes over P10. David's going to be P11. Dion, he's looks like Rangers heads to pit lane. What is going on with him? Wow. I'll tell you what, Rangers, when he is on it, he is absolutely on it. But right now, his race so far at Saudi Arabia is not going the way he planned. Meanwhile, Mayor of Bag City increasing that gap to 2 seconds. Jacob has since overtaken that second position. Culture is about a little over a second behind, so not quite sure what happened between these guys. Jacob NASCAR, he is right here, P10. So far, our top six drivers are exactly where they started in the race. Blue Husky and J-Mac Attack are the biggest movers of the night so far, both gaining 5 positions. Great run by these two. Rangers. Tough to see, man. 13 seconds behind. Oh no, it's Shames. Catching up to a driver right here, has fresh tires. Let's take a look and see what kind of tire compound they're using. We have Rangers on the hard, so he's going out for the long run. Also, David and Shames is gonna make the pass right here. The rest of these guys on medium tire compound. Dion in the pits also. That's a no. That's a no for me. Mayer extremely strong. I know he was doing really well last week, had pole, but immediately as soon as the race started, I almost thought that he let Rangers go by as to try to catch up later, you know, save the tires, but he was never able to do so. Last season, he had quite a few wins. He had 4 wins, but not enough to win the championship. Culture had 2 wins last season, and Rangers just with an incredible 9 wins out of 16 races. Teammate Jacob, 2 seconds behind, doing a fantastic job. He's got some fans out here. I know JC was out here watching earlier. Incredible talent with him. He's got to compete against his teammate, though. Ferrari out 1-2 at the moment, but you know Jacob, he wants that win. He's going to try. Closing that gap a little bit also. Down to a second. just a little over 2 seconds. Jacob with another penalty. We have Polish with a penalty, and we have Dion with a penalty. Three drivers so far. Jacob with 9 seconds. Dion with 5. Man, oh man, not what you want to see here. Mindless, how are you? Hulcher sitting P3. These guys are really, really spread out. A nice distance between Hulcher and Bloomy. A little over 4.5 seconds. So Hulcher not too worried. He's just worried about what's in front of him, trying to hit his marks and close that gap a little bit. Polish definitely going to have to watch it. He's got Justin directly behind him. So that is something. He's got a 6 seconds and penalties. If he doesn't increase that gap by the time this race is over, he will lose P5. Mindless, glad you're doing good. Giving Fiona a treat. Nice, nice, nice. Let's go and look at J-Mac attack. We're going to have Culture and J-Mac both in the top 10. P3 and P7, that's going to be for Mercedes out here. So doing a great job. A lot of these guys, man, I'll tell you what, tough competition. No safety cars yet. Knock on wood, lap 7 of 25. Pokey fan, P8. Not too far behind J-Mac attack. David has moved up P9 so far. Back about 3 seconds, you can see some of these drivers. Jacob, 9 seconds in penalty. P10, though, he did great in qualifying. Husky, what happened to you? Man, oh man. Yes, come join me in the booth. Let's see if I can invite you. Are you still in Justin's party? Are you guys are like anonymous? I can't see you. Send me a message and I'll get you in. You can help me out because you're more informed about F1 than I am. Sorry, multitasking. Back wing damage. Aw, man, that's rough. I wish they had replays. That would be so nice. Jacob keeping really even with his teammate out here. I want to see these two battle for the lead. Culture losing a little bit of time. You can see him on the map. The gap is definitely increasing between second and third. Bloomy, he's got about 6 seconds between him and Culture. So Culture still nothing to worry about behind him. But man, oh man, having a hard time closing that gap here. Where's your chat? I don't see anything. Why do I not see anything? All right, let's see here. We'll get this figured out. Maybe it just takes a second. Did it just go to like La La Land? Like, what is this? I don't think we're friends. Oh, I think I saw you somewhere. Here we go. We'll get there. I know I need to friend you. Husky, welcome to the booth.
Thank you. Now, that's exactly what I was afraid of. was coming off of the last part of Sector 1 and having those tires step out on you, because you also have the fuel distribution that you have to worry about. So it kicked my car over, and next thing I know, I'm backing up into the wall, and it caused my rear end to malfunction.
I was talking about that also, that I was worried about the first turn in the race, and I was saying, you know, some of the other drivers were worried about one of the final turns in Sector 1, and that is apparently what took you out of the race. So unfortunate. But yeah, do you think we're going to see any safety cars tonight?
I don't think we will, seeing that the biggest problem is going to be behind the leaders. Towards the rear of the field, I don't think that we're going to see much come out other than just your regular old sector cautions. Now, as you see, Mayor Back City, he's in that section that I've been worrying about all weekend. He's
on the rim. Oh, man, Mayor Back City, he absolutely, yeah, man, not what he wants to see.
Distribution.
I think we just gave him the booth curse here.
That fuel distribution has shifted over on him, and it backfired on him because he got such into a rhythm that he could not redo his tires there, and he just ended up kissing that wall.
Absolutely a heartbreaker for Mayor of Bag City. His teammate is going to benefit from that, though. New leader, Jacob X99. How about that? Lap 10 of 25. Now, can he keep it consistent? Try not to. You're talking about the fuel distribution, so... Oh, man, tough part of the track. I did not realize that part of the track was that challenging to go through.
Yeah, with the sweeping, as fast as that section is, it's the turns that you have to make. See, in the previous games, you had the fuel mix that you could adjust to make it a richer fuel mix or a thinner. You had different options there, but this game took that out of there, and that's really causing issues.
So unfortunate. And he went to pits and unfortunately got a speeding penalty heading in. 5-second penalty for Mayor of Back City. He's going to come out so far P9, but that just absolutely destroyed his chance for a win here tonight, unless we get a safety car and something miraculous happens. But Jacob still in the lead. Culture is going to be 7 seconds behind. Justin moves up to P3, about 8 seconds behind Culture. Is there any way that you see Culture catching Jacob out here, Husky?
The only thing I can see is pit stops. I mean, it takes approximately 20 seconds to go from the beginning of pit lane to the end of pit lane and getting out of there. So there is a possibility, but you've got to keep going. You got to keep hitting your marks. You got to keep hitting those.
Consistency is just huge.
Because if you don't, the slightest bit of slowness can end up getting you.
Right.
As Jacob cuts in now.
Our leader comes in. Culture, we'll see if he will be next in line to head to the pits. Let's take a look.
Now, the question is, will Culture stay out a couple of more laps? Maybe get a little bit of a distance. I don't know if it will work out all too much, but last week, I did that to try to stay out on soft tires. Ran a little bit extra on my softs from last week, and I did gain enough, but I didn't gain too much to where I could gain a position from the penalty from the driver ahead of me.
Man, oh man, that's another thing. We have a lot of drivers with some penalties out here. Jacob with the most, 12 seconds for him. Next up, we're going to have Polish Hammer. He is currently sitting P5 with a 6-second time penalty. Mayor of Bag City, he is up to P8 with 5 seconds. Dion also has incurred a 5-second penalty with Rangers, who was unable to qualify. He's up to P9, unfortunately, with a 3-second penalty. These drivers, if they want to keep that position, they will have to stay whatever penalty that they have, that amount ahead, at least, of the driver behind him. Otherwise, they will be giving up that position.
Something I'm noticing out of there, or on that sweeping left-hand turn there, coming out of Sector 1, I'm noticing a lot of, and maybe it's just the NASCAR in a lot of us, we're sticking down to that bottom lane. It's like any time that we go to a somewhat of a resemblance-banked corner, we just stick to that low line. That's not the line you should be running here, but we somehow make it work. Now, we got pit stops coming in. Three of our four leaders have came in.
Right.
Let's see how this all ravels out.
Yeah, Culture is on his way out. Let's see where he comes in play as he heads to the track. He's going to come out P3, so great for him. Polish Hammer moves up to P2. Jacob is our new leader so far. Bloomy with a 3-second time penalty. He is up to 6 seconds and penalties for him. Polish, though, how about that? Moving up to P2.
No, as much as I love these leaders, let's look at the fifth and sixth spot. They're battling for fourth place. They're trying to pass each other in the turns. That's not going to go on so well. But we got a pass here.
Yeah.
Bag City moves up one spot.
Yeah, it looks like David is just going to let him go on by. He knows he's faster. He's got to get moving. So Mayer's got a lot to catch up with. 5 seconds and penalties, unfortunately. Hokie fan's going to be the next in line that he's going to try to catch. And man, he is right there. He is getting ready to make a pass on him, going side by side into the S's here out of the corner. And he makes that move going up to P4. Great move by him. I mean, when he's got something to do, he is on a mission, and he's going to try to do as quickly as he can, and he's doing a great job trying to catch back up.
I'm watching to telemetry, and there's nothing but 8% of the ERS, man. It's hard with these cars to control the ERS in this new car. The fact that it just wears the battery down so much. And sometimes, again, this game does not allow you to control it as much as you used to. So to try to save as much energy as possible, but trying to catch up, you got to find the perfect balance.
Absolutely. You know, I've only raced this with, like, assist and everything. So I tried on the last game to do it without assist, and that did not go very well. So I'm just in awe on how you guys can maneuver through these tracks and able to get those lines down, and your braking points and acceleration points. It's pretty incredible how these guys are able to handle these tracks, because it is a lot more difficult than it looks.
Well, and again, these are street courses here back to back, which makes it a lot tougher to get around, especially when it comes to our race next week. But to hit those marks, it takes a lot of practice. I mean, when you're going through these race courses, especially the street tracks, it took me 2-3 years just to learn how to do Baku in Australia, right? Let alone the other race tracks. But
I can imagine.
Are just a completely a different beast.
Yeah, I can imagine. Jacob going through a lap 15 of 25 through the first sector here, the first turn. Culture is going to be almost 10 seconds behind him, so quite the gap for Jacob. We've talked about it. He's just got to be consistent, hit those marks, and so far he is doing it. I want to take a look at what tire compound these drivers are on, and every driver out there is on the hard tire compound except for Dion. He's on 9 lap-old tires on the medium compound, so we'll see if he comes in again. David heads into pits, and he's going to come out medium tires.
Now, what's going to be interesting here, in my opinion, is going to be this 5th through 7th spot. You see those intervals between each driver, and you see the penalties that they have.
Yes.
Or the points themselves. This is going to be something that we need to keep eye on.
Absolutely. Ranger's got that 3-second time penalty. He is 0.8 behind Justin, though, so take a look at that. That is something brewing up here with the battle. Polish Hammer is directly behind him. Well, I can't say directly, but about 4.5 seconds. He also has 9 seconds in penalties. If the race were to end at this moment, he would lose that position, as Bloomy is not too far off from him, but also has 6 seconds. So a lot of math going on through your head to see what these drivers would end up with.
Always do, and Hokie just got a 3 second. More likely for cutting corners, as I saw him cut through the corners through that one section again. And sometimes your car is just going to run wide in that sector. Doesn't surprise me that there's enough penalty conserved.
Yeah, it's easy to do here, absolutely. It's going side by side and turns it, coming around the corner. Trying to get himself straight once again. Gonna have to back it up and get moving. But man, oh man. Just tough break for some of these drivers. Hopefully not too much damage. Trying to take a look here.
Battle of teammates, fourth and fifth.
Let's go back, Rangers and Justin. That is gonna be for Aston Martin. And you can take a look right here. Leaf Justin directly behind Rangers. Rangers has that 3 second time penalty. So he's going to have to try to keep it clean, keep those penalties down to a minimum. Justin, he's ran a very clean race, and he's in the top five. He's looking really, really good.
I was afraid he was going to lose some time to his teammate because he took that one turn a little too wide out of the racing groove, but he somehow was able to keep it as close as he's got it.
Yeah, staying pretty consistent, I'll say. Just under a second gap between the two. Justin, I know that he's pretty good under pressure. If he's chasing the rabbit, it's going to help him know those lines and kind of keep his focus on what's ahead of him and just keep that consistent. So you can already see him. He's already down to a 0.5. I'm assuming DRS possibly in play right there. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. But that time, not the best exit for him. Rangers is going to take that away just a little bit, but he's still right there, Husky.
That DRS, man, I wish you would have saw it. We had a three-way battle coming out of the last turn. We went three wide down the front stretch into turn one. It was pretty crazy, but anything can happen on that front straightaway. Even if
Absolutely.
You think that it can happen, it can happen. So that's the thing about the front straightaway. You get just the right speed coming off that turn. Who can't you pass?
Here they come around this nice bend here.
All right, you took it a little wide that time.
Yeah. Let's take a look at the gap between them. 0.6, so it is staying very consistent. And I know, oh, Rangers, he goes around the corner and absolutely just bends it heading in. I don't know that he hit anything though, luckily. So he is off and running once again, but Polish is going to be able to pass him up, take over. P5 right there. Rangers going to move down to 6. Devastating race for Rangers out here. Like I said, when he is on it, he is definitely on it. But when he has a trouble night, it goes from the get-go. And that is what his night, that's what we're seeing tonight here so far.
Well, I'm sitting here, I'm looking at all these great battles going on in the midfield. Jacob is just absolutely knocking it out of the park. He's got a 10-second lead over his teammate, Mayer. And it's already got the one stop taken care of. If he can just keep it clean, he's got this one in the back.
Yeah, I was just watching Mayer and Kulture. Mayer just passed him up. So we're going to see if Kulture hangs on behind him. But Jacob and Mayer, this Ferrari team, so incredibly strong out here. The constructor standings, it's going to be very, very close for these guys. But I'll tell you what, Rangers, his race tonight, definitely hurting him out there. Sitting P5, he has since passed Polish Hammer up. Will he be able to catch his teammate once again?
Bloomy has DNF'd. That was the caution in Sector 1.
I hate to see it. I hate to see it. He was having a really, really good race out there. Man, oh man. Lumi and Hokie, McLaren teammates right there. Hokie is in the top 10 now. 3 second time penalty. Bloomy is now DNF'd. Just really hard to see. Jacob in 11th. Oh no, it's Shames in 12th. Quite the gap between these drivers. Crazy. Dion gonna be in 13th, and Husky unfortunately had that mishap, and he's with me here in the booth. Jacob still leading though, almost 10 second interval. So pretty crazy. What'd you say, Husky?
I get the best seat in the house. I don't have to worry about hitting those marks, especially in this sector that Mayor's in right now. Especially with Coulter right behind him. It can be really nerve-wracking going through this sector.
Yeah. Coulter definitely putting the pressure on him. 0.8 behind. You know he's feeling the pressure, trying to keep it up, trying to keep that speed up, stay consistent, hit his marks. But he's got a lot to catch up to Jacob. And I've said it a couple times, I want to see Jacob get a win. I know he had JC out here earlier rooting him on. What a race, man. Oh, Mayor of Bag City.
Oh, Rick.
Husky. Twice. DNF for him. DNF.
Safety car out.
Our first safety car of the night that is going to be brought out by Mayor of Bag City, who his car is destroyed, no longer in the race. Heartbreaker for him.
Well, that just even the entire field up, especially if you're not one lap down, let alone two. But
what's your mindset if you're Jacob right now? You have this huge gap. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking I might need new set of tires. Because I've been out on there for a while. I got this 10-second gap. And as we see, Coulter coming in for a pit stop. Always having a new fresh tires in these situations is always great. But you also got to worry about who's got what.
Right.
You see Coulter take the soft tires as he's going to get passed there by David, probably one lap down. I ain't got that bit of information, but I don't know if he's went in or not, but
Justin takes soft tires also.
He's on them hard tires.
We have a lot of drivers coming out with soft tires, medium tires, and he's out there on the hard. That's a tough call. That is a tough, tough call. You know he's got the speed for it, but now they are all gathered up together. Things are going to get a little aggressive. We're going to see... I think we might see some casualties here.
Well, the one thing that you definitely got, if you're Jacob, is when am I going to restart this race? Because the field's going to pile up, and they're going to have to wait for you, and you have... or you cannot pass any driver until you get to that timing line. Until then, it will be a penalty if you do pass.
Right. It's pretty strict with how far of a distance you have to keep between the driver ahead of you. So I don't know really how that works. So you'll have to tell me, isn't it like a certain amount of seconds or like a distance?
The rules state that it's 10 seconds, I believe it is. I know there was some controversy in the live F1 in 2020 about that. I think it's 10 seconds, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay. Here comes Jacob.
Here comes Jacob.
Yeah.
I don't know where he was on track, but doing it now, that might be, well.
Yeah, he's going to lose that position. That's tough. That's tough. Man.
A brand new softs, though.
Brand new softs. You know he's got the speed. But we have Coulter there. And then David has also passed him up now. So he's going to have a little bit to go through. David has 6 lap old tires on the medium tire compound. So, man, tough. This is coming down to the wire. Lap 21 of 25. I'm nervous for him. I want to see him get this win. I love Coulter to death also. Would love to see him get this win. But, man, Jacob, he's done a phenomenal job out here. So we'll see how he takes it for these final few laps.
This is one more thing that I just love about this sport is Now I'm saving up my ERS as much as possible. Because once that gets going, you know the driver ahead of you is going to use it to try to keep up with that gap, if not pass, when it comes out. Now, this is a safety car, so once we go back green, DRS will be disabled until two laps after.
Right. Yeah, that's going to make it very interesting with that also. A couple of things in their pocket they can use. Will it be enough, Jacob? Is David to compete with? He's got culture to compete with, and he's got a lot of hungry drivers that are going to be right behind him. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Turn one, as you are restarting, that is going to be a huge thing that these drivers are going to try to go in all at the same time. So we'll see if they can survive that. And we've had a couple of drivers have an issue with a couple of the turns heading into the final part of Sector 1. We'll see how they handle that. I'm nervous, Husky. Oh, I'm on the edge of my seat.
I am too, especially with these time penalties really coming into focus. I'm with a 3-second penalty.
Yeah, we can't forget about that.
Hold on to that second spot.
Oh,
same thing with Leaf and Rangers. They might go down to 6th and 7th, for all I know, because of these penalties.
Yeah, that's a huge thing. It's totally different once they were all divided up and huge gaps, but that is no longer the case. There's a lot of positions to be lost here in the final few laps. Culture, I assume he is just getting ready to drive his heart out. He's going to have to nail everything. Keep his eye on the guys behind him. See where they're headed. Because he's going to have some drivers try to send it into these corners. And it may not turn out well. So we'll see how he fares. Evan, next week we are headed to Baku.
Oh, you can't say Azerbaijan, huh?
Azerbaijan.
There you go. This is stuck.
I kind of figured that's how you'd say it, but, you know, just in case. Just in case. Evan, let me know if you've ever raced there. It is a wild, wild track. I remember from last season, I haven't touched on this game.
I remember barely touching the wall going up the castle section, and I just see my wheel pop off the car.
Oh no.
you're just off in that one little section and you're done for.
Yeah, open wheel racing, very unforgiving with contact like that. Although I can tell you the NASCAR portion, safety car in this lap. We're getting ready to go back here. I'm nervous.
Culture is the official pace car at this time.
Let's go. All right, here we go, Culture. A lot is riding on these final few laps. So much going through these drivers' mind, but we are getting ready to go back to racing. Heading to lap 23 of 25. These guys are off and running. Take a look. Yeah, we're going to have these guys trying to make a move. Jacob! What a great power move making his way past David. Can he do it again to Culture, or will Culture defend his position as the leader here? This race is quickly coming to an end. Sector 1 caution.
That late pit stop might have helped.
Take a look.
David with the spin, Sector 1.
Yeah, I saw that. Loses a lot of positions from this.
Side by side going into the turn for first place.
Jacob unable to make that pass. He's going to try it again. Culture trying to defend that position as much as he can, using every piece of the track. Jacob right behind him, Justin about 2.5 seconds back with a 3-second time penalty. He's got his teammate on his bumper. There we go, Rangers for the pass. That's going to be for P3. We have battles brewing all over the place, Husky.
Yeah, just as what I thought was going to happen. Chaos. right now, if I'm anybody in that third on back, I gotta be J-Mac. The two cars ahead of me, they're on 3 seconds. I gotta keep up with them. Because guess what? I'm on the podium and I get more points.
Here we go. A little bit of contact with that wall, but J-Mac attack is gonna be P4. Jacob gets a 132.1 fastest lap of the session.
Contact between the Mercedes of J-Mac attack and Leaf Justin.
Man, these guys really all over those curbs. Lap 24 of 25. Jacob, little over half a second behind Culture. Will Culture get the win here? First win of the season. It's going to be close. It is going to be very, very close.
It's going to come down to the DRS zone coming in, coming up here in the second sector and on the front stretch. If you're Jacob, you have to get a great sector between here and exit of that final corner.
These guys are remaining so even, but Jacob had a little bit better exit than Culture did. Gained a tenth on that, but this is getting so close.
Because when it comes, one of the things when it comes to F1 is, do you rather be better on the turns and not so great on the straightaways, or are you great on the straightaways but not so much the turn? There's a little give and take. It'd be up to you on your track on what you want to do.
Absolutely. Polish just passed up Leif Justin, but Polish has a 12-second time penalty. DRS is enabled. Final lap. Jacob is going to to figure out something. When to use it, how to use it. He's going to go too wide almost. Oh, unable to do so.
I would have took that chance going into turn one with all the chips on the table.
When is his next time to make a move?
It's going to be in that banked corner at the end of sector one. You'd have to think it, especially if Culture decides that it's going to run wide. Let's see what happens here.
Here he goes. He's trying to running wide. He's going to cut underneath. Side by side. Will they be able to hold on to it? Jacob takes the lead. Culture in second. Man, what a move. Will Culture be able to answer back? He's going to cut that piece of the track right there. Right. Man, I am surprised he did not get penalized.
DRS coming into effect, and we're side by side again, coming down into the end of sector two.
Take a look at this battle. I'm getting goosebumps. Culture takes back the lead. We are coming down to the final corner. What will he be able to do? Jacob trying to look and trying to get that lead back side by side once again, heading into the final corner.
Culture. Got the DRS.
He's got the DRS. He's got the lead. He is going to be the winner here at Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. Huge congratulations to him. What an incredible battle. Culture is going to come out in second. J-Mac attack. How about that? He's going to get a podium finish here. Rangers, after not qualifying and a few mishaps during the race, he's going to bring out a top five with the P4. Teammate Justin, he is going to be a top five driver. Hokey Fan in sixth, Polish Hammer in seventh. But I don't want to forget the time penalties here. Is this after time penalties, or are they still going to configure that?
Well, it should be already. The time penalties should already be added onto the time. I think between the time of finish, there was enough.
Fair enough.
For the drivers to really stay in their positions. So I don't think it hurt the drivers that had a penalty. There.
What a race. What a race. Jacob 99 is your winner. He's going to head to victory lane and celebrate. Rangers driver of the day. Huge comeback for him. Mayor of Bag City, absolutely heartbroken for him.
So, pitting late there for Jacob actually did pay off there at the end. I didn't think it would.
I was nervous for him. He did. Man, You know, when you have those late safety cars, so many things, so many different strategies can come into play, and luckily he made the right call this time. All right, let's try to bring these drivers in here. That is so true. So true. All right. Let's get him. We need culture. Here we have Jacob. Jacob, do you have a copy?
Yes.
What a wild, wild race. You had a very fast car tonight. First of all, you were battling your teammate. How was that going between you and Mayor?
Yeah, I don't know if I was going to pass him, but catching him and being in the DRS was at least going to happen. Sucks to see him go out, but...
Absolutely.
Yeah, it would have been us on the top.
All right. And then we saw the safety car come out late race. What was going through your mind? You had a nice lead there. What were you going through your mind there?
Yeah, I've seen some VSCs go so quick that if you pit, it's going to be a net loss for you. And I didn't know yet if it was going to be extended or not. And then once I saw we were slowing down, I was like, this sucks. I definitely just blew it. But thankfully, the only one catching up was one. And I didn't think I'd have a shot, but turn one to be right on his bumper. I knew we had a 3-lap battle. We were going to have the DRS to end it, so we'd have a fair scrap, man. It was close.
Like, it was very close.
I was shaking when it was done.
I bet
we
you were.
The whole time. And then at the very end, it's like, here we go. Even all the way until the final turn, I had to push it high. But now, yeah, that was an awesome ending.
What made your safety car pit stop decision? Was it, these guys are coming in behind me taking new tires and I need new tires? Or was it just
a
situation where you were out of there?
There was such little time left, I thought, and it wasn't for sure to me if we were going to get the full safety car. If we just got the virtual, I would have kept the lead I had because no tires would not have mattered with 3 laps to go. So I was basically with the thinking it was a VSC. And like has happened before, the moment I passed pit road, it's like, nope, we're slowing down. So it was a mistake looking back, but I wasn't convinced we'd actually slow down yet. So I just kept the lead.
Well, but you did
it.
And
it worked out.
Yeah, you did an incredible job. And what a battle for the final couple of laps. I mean, absolutely incredible. Huge congratulations to you for the win and a great way to start the season here. A win already, so
thanks.
Yeah. How do you feel about next week? We're heading to Baku.
Where are we going?
Baku,
that track. I haven't
Baku.
Been there a whole lot on this game, but I mean, since it's unique.
Yeah.
And we get to slow down a bunch, like, I'm ready for it.
That's what I like to hear. Well, congratulations to you. Go celebrate. All right, Husky. Culture, he came second. That battle was just insane. You want to go ahead and give him an interview?
Sure. So coming into the pit there on the late caution, I know that's going to be the big questions I'm asking here. Why did you pit when you did? What was going through your head of, hey, I need to pit? What do you think Jacob was going to end up doing? And when or if he was going to pit, and how do you think that was going to play out?
I expected Jacob to pit, to be honest. I don't think I really had a choice. I mean, last week I had too much downforce. This week I had too little downforce. I mean, I didn't really have a choice. I had to pit. I had to try something. And, I mean, I came up short in the end, but it was close.
That was going through my mind. You went into pit first compared to him. I'm wondering how your tires under caution compared to his laps under caution with his fresh soft tires played in effect on that. Were you playing more conservative when it came to you being in third place compared to any of the other drivers? Were you trying to save anything there for the end before that safety car came out?
I wouldn't say really trying to save. I was just trying to keep my car in one piece. I mean, once I saw Mayor spin around and he had his little trouble, and then later on he ended up DNFing, I just had to keep pace. I mean, I didn't have too fast of a car. I mean, I did almost win, but it wasn't too fast of a car.
And the last question I asked for you, the fuel loads. I know that was an issue for me, the way the fuel was shifting around in my cars. What caused my DNF was a fuel shift, and I ended up hitting the back of my car to tear off my rear ring. How did you handle that on this track?
I don't know. I only got loose like once or twice. I did put a little. I tried taking out more fuel before the race, but I still ended up having like 4+ laps of extra fuel. I don't know really, to be honest.
Honestly, that's just something that we need to get back in these games, is being able to manage that fuel, my opinion. But congratulations on a second place. Are you ready for next week? What's your thoughts?
Yeah, I'm ready for next week. I think we're probably going to see a bit more cautions because it's a bit of a tighter track, but yeah, I'm ready.
And again, enjoy the second place, and hopefully we can get some great racing at Baku. Frozen, back over to you.
All right, we have J-Mac running out the podium here. Man, you had a wild race also. How did your race go, and how did you make your way up to P3?
I mean, yard sailed it in qualifying, so started dead last. That was fun, and then everyone was about 5 wide into turn 1. I was trying to take it easy, and that still wasn't easy enough, and bounced off a couple of things, somehow never got damaged. I mean, I'm pretty sure my car looked like it was at Martinsville. But yeah, just tried to take it easy and work through the field and make some passes when I could, and was actually able to. Actually had a car decent enough. I'm goal scoring points for Team Mercedes. Had some setup help from my boys over at Aston Martin, so props to them. It's kind of fun. All of us kind of right there in a row, all of my allies on the track, I should say, kind of around each other there. But yeah, just had fun, made laps. I mean, that's the goal for this thing. Try not to. Obviously, you want to take it seriously when you're out there, but try not to stress too much over it. Just show up and have fun and not worry about where we finish. And got to have some pretty fun racing, some pretty good clean racing with Hokey for a lot of the race. I got loose at one point and killed the right rear. That's a broken toe link in a cup car on iRacing, and somehow the right rear survived and was able to keep going. And hey, we ended up making our way up. And then of course we had the goofy safety car, which always seems to happen at the end here. That happened last season at Saudi Arabia, and again it happened. And obviously had to pit and then survive, and a couple of fast guys got some damage and was able to pass them, and we finished fourth on the track, but thanks to some penalties we looked into a podium. So hey, I'll take it. we will move forward. So wherever we're going next week, I don't know. We'll make some laps when the practice lobby opens.
Think Castle Azerbaijan, for next man. Week.
Oh yeah, Baku. Yeah, that's right, Azerbaijan.
Yes. It should be a fun one. It's one of those that I'm glad I'm in the booth. But man, J-Mac, what a great race for you, from the incident in qualifying, moving your way up through the field, quite a few battles, and finishing out in P3. No complaints, definitely fun race for you. So huge congratulations. That's it for us this week. Next week, you heard it, we're going to be headed to Azerbaijan. So I hope to see you guys there. It'll be around 8 p.m. Eastern time. We'll see if we see some safety cars out there, but man, a clean race, a wild couple of final laps. If you didn't get to watch it, make sure and watch the final couple of laps after the VOD comes up. You won't be disappointed. Great race between Jacob Coulter and several others. So have a great night. Thank you for tuning in, for the follows, and for hanging out. You guys are awesome. We'll see you next week. Alrighty, that was crazy. That was a wild lap. Good job, Jacob. Good job, Coulter.